Hello.
Oh, well, hey.
You have made it back to Three Northwest.
I did.
Good. Operation went really, really well.
Oh, good.
They're already working on the cells in the lab.
Wow.
I probably won't get a chance to check in on them for a couple weeks, and then we'll know kind of what's going on. You shouldn't have any restrictions to lifting.
Okay.
Although, if you want me to, I will say that you have restrictions from housework.
Yes, vacuuming would be great.
Yeah, I think those might be a little too difficult for you this
week. I
think
so.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Absolutely. Not a problem. Not a problem.
Appreciate.
Having successfully gone through surgery, Anita McAllister will be sent home for 3 weeks, while Dr. Goff waits for her immune cells to grow.
Every person that comes in here and allows us to treat them on an experimental protocol, they are clearly hoping for a cure. They come to us, they trust us, and we have to repay that.
Two more, we're doing really good. Blowing and deep breath. Good, thank you.
It's been a while since you get to move your legs like this, hey, Bull? Must be nice. Yeah, go ahead, kick him.
Oh!
Yeah, he misses kickboxing, that's for sure.
Bo was put on steroids yesterday and hopes to get the inflammation down a bit. His response has been a good one. His spirits are high, lots of smiles today, and that's a good thing.
Hey. Hey, Bo. You're awake. I don't know whether you heard we started lower doses of steroids yesterday, okay? Not because of trying to shut the cells off, but because your body didn't seem to be making enough of its own steroids. We're gonna try to come down off the steroids this week so we can let the cells expand a little better. But your dad asked really, and your mom and Irish asked important questions about whether we knew for sure that by giving the steroids, the cells wouldn't expand. And what I told them is that we don't know that giving the steroids is going to prevent the cells from expanding. I know it was something we talked about and it was something you were worried about. But, you know, and remember this, the doses are low. So we're going to come down on the steroids as best we can over the weekend, okay? Are you asking why we gave the steroids? Are you worried about the steroids? Yeah. Bo, you were pretty sick. You still are. I don't think we had a choice but to give at least some steroids. And we just made a plan with the ICU team to try to come down on those steroids over the next couple days, okay?
I just want to reassure you, I know that the decision for Dr. Fry about the steroids was made with a big group of team people, the ICU team, the infectious disease team. We all got together and talked about it, so it wasn't a light decision. But you needed to feel better before the chance of the cells expanding. Because you were needing oxygen and support for your blood pressure.
So you want to write something? Mm-hmm. Add more cells. You know, you're asking if I can add more cells right now. Right now, Bo, I don't even know if the cells are going to expand. That we're just going to have to wait and see. When is that? Next week, I think we'll have a much better handle on it. Probably next Wednesday. The important thing is you seem to be doing better today, okay? All right, my friend, we'll see you tomorrow, okay? All right. I'm certainly more optimistic about his clinical condition overall, but, you know, if 3, 4, 5 days from now, there's been nothing that has happened to suggest that those cells are expanding, we'll always wonder, you know, whether or not the need to give the steroids was the cause of that.
P2. People who bravely participate in first-in-human medical research are on a journey into the unknown. Unexpected side effects, dangerous changes to hormones or organ function, and the psychological toll of alternating hope and despair all must be managed by doctor and patient alike. It is this reality that makes experimental medicine all the more incredible.